Hey, what's up? It's Jared with Stata Tech. So say you have a hard drive, a 1 terabyte hard drive like I have right here, and you have an iPad. Maybe it's the new iPad Pro 2018 11 inch, or maybe it's the previous year iPad, and you don't want to spend all of that money to get that external storage. You're thinking, I would love to have 512 or a terabyte of storage space on your iPad, but you don't want to spend that money because you already have a hard drive. And we already know that we can't plug this hard drive directly into an iPad, so what do? Well, you use this cool device from RavPower to connect and then get access to all of that storage and more. Let's take a look. All right, so here we are with the iPad, and we have our 1 terabyte Samsung hard drive here. And so this is going to work regardless of what kind of hard drive you have, as long as it can, of course, be powered. If it's a small hard drive like this, like a solid state drive, or a small bus powered, which means it will be powered by the cable itself here, you can actually, this is all you're going to need. But if it's a bigger hard drive, like one of the bigger external hard drives, you're actually still going to need to plug that into its power source, but we're going to be able to connect a very large hard drive to an iPad, which means you don't necessarily have to buy a large iPad. I know that Apple wants you to buy that 1 terabyte, spend that almost $2,000 on an iPad, but you just simply don't have to do that, especially if you already have a hard drive. All you're going to need is this RavPower device here, which is an inexpensive device, well under $100. I picked this one up on Amazon for $65. And what this device allows you to do is connect a variety of things to your iPad. And it's great because now we can connect any hard drives that we have to our iPad so that we can copy over video content, copy over photos, whatever it is, stream stuff straight off of our hard drive. It's amazing. So beyond the RAV power device, you're actually going to need the RAV File Hub app. Now, once you turn this on and configure it, you have to connect to the device. It puts off its own Wi-Fi network and it kind of acts as a router. It's not a hotspot, but it acts as a router. So what you can actually do is connect to this device, and then you can connect this device to a Ethernet cable, such as this Ethernet cable right here, and it can actually provide a Wi-Fi connection to your device as well. So this would work really good. Say you were at a hotel room and they provide internet through a cable, but if you want Wi-Fi, it's gonna cost you money. You bring this device, you connect their cable to it, and then it's gonna produce a Wi-Fi signal for all of your devices to connect to. Pretty awesome. So we've got our hard drive here and we have our RAV power router here. We're gonna open up the File Hub, which connects to this device. And we can either just put our SD card from our camera in here, or we can connect a hard drive to it. Obviously, the purpose of this video is to connect a hard drive to it, so we're going to do that. So we're going to grab our hard drive here, and I'm just simply going to plug it in, and let's make some room for all this stuff here. Scoot this over. And you can see it's starting to connect, and we should see a notification pop up in the app here letting us know. Disk detected, there it is. We have now 931-ish gigabytes of storage connected, and how much is available. Obviously, I have a lot of stuff on this drive already. So if I click on File Management, I'm accessing this drive right now. That is amazing. And just to show you how fast it is, let's go into a previous video project. I did a video which is on the Canon 80D camera almost 3 years later, because it's almost 3 years old, for Ditch Auto, another YouTube channel that I do. And this video is 4.41 gigabytes and it is 4K. I wonder how long it'll take to start playing it. It's gonna load a little bit of that video. It's doing all this wirelessly, keep in mind. Boom, and it's already playing. It's already playing that video.
Hey, what's up? It's Jared with Ditch Auto, and today I wanted to talk about the Canon 80D.
Oh. How cool is that? Okay, so of course we can stream content from a hard drive, which is great. For those of you with a bunch of movies and stuff on a hard drive, very easy to do that. What about copying content from a hard drive over to your iPad or vice versa? very simple to do that. So let's go into one of these folders and let's just see what we can find and copy over. So we've got a whole bunch of like DNGs and JPEGs, so raw images and JPEG images here. So if we click around on some of these, they should open up and we can actually view them. It's a photo of my daughter right here. And of course the entire app runs in landscape mode, but then of course when you look at a photo, it opens it up in portrait mode for whatever reason. There we go, we got it back. So you can see here it's like giving me previews, and look how fastly I could like toggle through these images and just scroll through them. It's amazing how fast this is wireless. This is wireless, folks. So there's a few things that we could do. I could like hit play and it just does like, I think it does a slideshow. And so I'd probably want to go and oh, there we go. So it's doing kind of a slideshow type of thing. Interesting. So we'll tap to stop that. So if you want to copy a file off of the hard drive, the best way is just to go back to the files, tap and hold here and choose copy to, and then choose iPad photos, and then you can choose one of your folders that you already have there on your internal storage, or of course you can create a new folder. I'm just going to tap all photos, and this is all the photos that I have on my iPad already, and I'll tap paste, and it's going to go ahead and download that image, and then I can go out into my Photos app, and I should be able to see that image. Oh, there it is right there, as one of the most recent downloads. So this is pretty exciting, being able to connect to a external hard drive and of course even get content off of my iPad onto an external to free up additional space. Let's go back to that RAV File Hub app. So you'll notice here that we have both the File Hub and the iPad here. So if I go to iPad and tap on iPad Photos and then come and choose from one of my folders, so we've got all of our different images folders. So say I go to All Photos, and I've got maybe like a couple of photos that I have from earlier. So we'll go to multi-select and choose just a couple of those. Maybe these are from dinner last night. I'll go ahead and hit copy to external storage. It automatically connects to that hard drive. I can go into my photos folder on the hard drive and then click paste, and it's actually now copying images. You can see the HEIC images off of my iPad onto a hard drive. So I mean, how amazing is this? Now we don't have to go and buy those extremely large iPads. If we already have a hard drive, it's very easy to connect that hard drive using this $60-ish device so that we can connect and have additional storage and not necessarily have to worry about spending that premium price with Apple. All right, so I hope you liked that video. We just added a terabyte of storage to an iPad without spending all that money using a hard drive we already had. And of course, we can use that hard drive for so many other things, like plugging it into our PC or our laptop or our Mac or whatever. Now we can use that storage for a lot of different things and not necessarily have to go out and spend all of that money on that iPad. So remember, links are down in the description below to the RAV power device that I was using and a couple of hard drives that I recommend as good solutions for connecting to your iPad. So make sure to check out those links. And thanks again for checking out this video. Click that subscribe button to be notified when we put out new videos, and give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Take care, and we'll see you back here in the next one.